Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know that how the molecular orbitals have been formed according to the LCO method. And now we are going to be talking about that how the formation of antibonding orbital along with that of the how the bonding molecular orbitals have been formed. So let us talk about that. In LCO method, we have got to know that the molecular orbitals can be represented by the electron wave function, and this represents the electronic wave, that is the wave function, that is psi A and psi B, that is what we have learned in our previous lecture. So in this case, basically, if we get to know that if the waves or if the wave function are of the same phase, then we could say that there will be addition of the wave function, and that is how the molecular orbitals can also be formed. But what if they are of opposite phase? So if they are of opposite phase, then we could say that they will subtract each other, and that is what we could say that antibonding orbitals would be formed. So this is what I wanted to clear in this case. Basically, the formation of the molecular orbitals, it is formed because of the addition, while the formation of the antibonding orbitals, it is formed because of the subtraction of the wave function. So that is what I'm going to talk about in this lecture. So basically, we know that there are two kinds of method, and from which basically the molecular orbitals have been formed, whether it would be bonding or whether it would be antibonding. So first thing is, by addition of the wave function. So if both the wave functions are been added, so that is what we have did in our previous lecture also, while taking an example, that is psi P, which was a combination of, or which was the addition of, that is psi A plus psi B. So this clearly indicates that the wave functions are being of the same phase and are combined in such a way that the bonding, that is molecular orbitals, has been formed. And this is what I could explain in this way also. Suppose if I am representing the electronic wave in such a way where I could say, and if I am combining these two, so this plus, this doesn't represent the proton or it doesn't represent the electron, it just represents the sign, because if we have got to know that is what is wave function, and then in that case we will get to know that the signs, that is positive or negative, it represents the whether they are in the phase or whether they are out of the phase. Suppose if this is the wave function that I'm talking about, and suppose if they are combining, so then we could see that whenever they will combine with each other in this way, suppose just an instant, if I would talk about, so if they are combining, then ultimately we could find that two of the wave function, or two of the atoms, when they are combined with each other, they will have basically the same electron density, or the probability of finding the electrons will be more, and this is how the two are being combined. So this has happened because of the two wave functions, if they have combined, or we could say that the addition method has been happened, and that is what the wave function this clearly indicates, that the bonding has been happened. But when we are talking about the antibonding, so let me talk about this one also with a few detail, that is whenever the wave functions are been combined and whenever the molecular orbitals are been formed, so it depends, it will also depend on the stability also, as well as it will also depends on the energy also. If the energy is very much less, then we could say molecular orbital is basically bonding orbital, and that is what it is represented by sigma. So this sigma is, it also indicates that how the atomic orbitals have overlapped on each other, and so as to form a stronger bond. While talking about the antibonding orbital, so antibody orbital is formed because of the subtraction. So therefore, this is the second method that I am talking about, that is by subtraction. So talking about this method, that is whenever the two atomic orbitals, they have been basically they are out of the phase, suppose, or they are of opposite phase, then only we could say that the antibonding orbitals will be formed. And that is what in the previous lecture also, that is by LCO method, we have represented in this way. That is where the two of the atomic orbitals are being subtracted with each other, and that is what the that is antibonding orbitals have been arranged. But talking about this one, suppose if I am representing it in this way, where I could see that the electron density, that is if suppose if they are of opposite phase, that is this one. So whenever the two atomic orbitals or whenever the two wave functions, if they are of opposite phase, then that's the reason that we have represented over here as minus. Then this would lead us to a formation of basically that would give us, we see the, there would be a nodal that we could observe over here, because there will be distribution of the electrons, and this is what I will observe. That is, in this case, basically, that will have an opposite phase, that is, one will be plus, while the other will be in minus. So therefore, the wave function can be represented with opposite phase, and that is what the subtraction is basically included in it. And we could say that they are not forming a bond, and the electron density is not being distributed. So this is what the nodal plane plays a vital role, or it makes us to understand that the two electron density or the electron density are being distributed, and that is what this nodal plane, it gives an idea that the two of the electrons are being distributed. So for an example, if I would say, that is, whenever the hydrogen molecule, like H2 suppose, for this I am talking, and whenever the two atomic orbitals, they combine with each other, so we have, it has been observed that the electron density, when we are talking about that is bonding molecular orbital, that the electron density is what we could find in this way, that is, they are over the nucleus, as you could see. But talking about the antibonding orbital, that is, then whenever this we observe about the antibonding molecular orbital, then it has been noted that the nucleus, suppose, or the electron density, suppose, if I am talking about, so now that is basically distributed, and not evenly distributed, as you could see that it is basically separated because of a nodal plane, if you will observe. So the electrons are being distributed here, but here electron density is being more, and we can find the more electron density over here, and that is what it creates a bonding molecular orbital, while this is basically antibonding molecular orbital. So this is what I was talking about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have gotten VS concept behind this. So I hope you share this video with the friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.